and welcome to Talk Bowling, episode 105. I'm John Congdon.
I'm Tony Rucco. Talk Bowling is proud to bring you the latest information from the bowling industry, bowling tips, and updates on the largest internet bowling website, bowlingball.com.
There you go. And I can see it in the window.
Oh, yeah. Nice.
Long story. Welcome back. Let's get into the questions.
All right, hit it.
First one's from Ed. Hi, Tony and John. I'm wondering how to determine whether to loft the ball onto the lane or to lay short for best results. I usually release the ball at foul line and let ball roll long through the oil to breaking point. I'm reading as he wrote it.
I can tell.
I use the dots at the foul line for release points. I should have rewrote this. Rather than arrows, which allows me to keep my head down and better follow through. I'm assuming he's talking about the first set of dots. I have found when I loft the ball 1 or 2 feet out onto the lane, I seem to lose revs and lift on the ball, and it slides out past the breaking point, and then I start to turn my wrist over too soon. Laying the ball short allows me to stay under the ball and get more revs and better reaction. I may have answered my own question, but watching Tony bowl with different layouts, he sometimes lofts the ball on release and sometimes lays shorter. Does a layout make a difference on release? Thanks, Ed. Well, since he's referring to your bowling style, I didn't even read the second half of the question.
Oh, no, you just kind
of... When I answered it.
Gave up halfway through? What'd you do?
I don't know.
Okay, well, I'll answer for me, I guess, then. No, I... When you see me sometimes get the ball out further on the lane or lay it down shorter, we do all of our ball testing on the same pattern. So, in that case, yes, it is based on the ball and the layout we chose on that ball. We try really hard to use very similar layouts. We don't get too crazy with our layouts. We try and make it where we're going to show you that ball at its best. That's our job to do, is to give you an honest reaction in a safe layout on a good pattern. So when you see me have to loft the ball a little bit, yeah, the ball may be a ball that tends to start up a little sooner. When you see me lay the ball down earlier, it may be a ball that needs a little bit more time on the lane to react and to read the pattern better. So as far as what to do, it sounds like you did kind of answer your own question, because you say when you lay the ball down short, it allows you to stay under the ball and get more revs and better reaction. So in my opinion, why would you ever want to loft it then?
Right.
I can't do what Mike Jones does, you know, using our other ball tester. I can't do that. I can't loft it to the arrows and still get the ball to hook.
Right.
For me to loft it to the arrows, I'm taking so much energy to do that, I can't do much more to it. So yeah. Maybe if I threw a 12-pound ball, I could, but he does it with a 14, 15-pound ball. So
that was my answer. When I first read the question, I answered quickly. I was referencing Mike in our latest videos. He does loft the ball crazy. On one of the videos, like you said, out to the arrows.
Yeah.
Seems like a little much, but it really depends on the oil condition. If the heads are really burnt up it's causing your ball to hook way too soon,
right?
Maybe you need to loft a little bit to get out past that.
And he naturally revs the ball up a lot. His rev rate, I mean, I don't know what the numbers are. I can tell you it's more than mine, and I'm higher than average. So he's revving the ball a ridiculous amount. So by getting the ball out on the lane further, it allows him to take part of the lane out of play, which for him is better. He only has to deal with, we'll say he only has to deal with that part of the lane. He takes the heads out of play. So for a guy like that, but for what you're describing, I would do what you're doing. It says, you know, when you lay the ball down short, it sounds like you get the ball reaction you want, you get the amount of revs you want. I wouldn't mess with lofting the ball unless you are on a condition that makes you loft the ball.
Right. And the ball uses that first couple feet of the lane to start to rev up, start to roll. I mean,
right.
You're using that first 2 feet for a purpose, where if you loft past it, it's going to take that much more time for the ball to react.
Right, taking it out of play. So
all right, hope that answers that question.
All right, I'll ask a question from TJ.
You do that.
TJ? I like the way they spell that. I currently throw a Storm Furious, which I know is supposed to be a fairly aggressive ball. This is not the case for me. The reason, however, is my fault. I can't get nearly as many revolutions on the ball as most bowlers out there. Unless the lanes are really dry, I can't get nearly as much hook on it as other bowlers who throw the same ball. Save from buying even a more aggressive ball, what are some things I can do to get more rotation on the ball?
Ah!
I had to leave that for you.
One of the greatest questions asked by bowlers.
Who types that? Who types out like a sigh?
I don't know. I did. I wrote ah. One of the great questions asked by bowlers all the time. But it is. How do I get more revs on the ball? And the biggest deterrent to hook potential is the same as for golf. It's all in timing, balance, follow through. So once you get those few pieces in place, the rest should start to work out.
Yeah, you have to be, it's a good analogy, I guess, with golf. The club has to be at the ball at the right point, and right. Your body and your arms and everything have to be with it. So in bowling, it's the same thing. That ball has to be at the right point at the bottom of your swing when you get to the foul line. And that takes timing, which takes practice, and it just takes time to get there. Right. So it is a timing issue. I believe it's more of a timing issue than anything else in the world. Mm-hmm. You're also dealing with balance, like John said. If you're not balanced at the foul line, you'll be falling all over the place. Mm-hmm. It's going to throw off the way your hand comes out of the ball. So I would really look at practicing those fundamentals first. And if you do need help, I've talked about it, and you've probably seen it over the years, put a wrist device on, mm-hmm. use that, help you get some more roll on the ball, revolutions on the ball, and then as you get better, you can probably take that off.
Right. I put a few on here. The balance is key, because if at the foul line you're more worried about whether you're going to fall or not, you're going to take some off the ball.
Yeah.
You have no choice. The follow-through is huge, but you need to be balanced in order to do that, and by following through, you're not just letting the ball come off your hands. You're
right.
Actually going to come through the ball, which will put more revolutions on it. One of the things that, when I was bowling league without Tony and another guy that worked for us, before league I would ask, what's my thought for tonight? And one of the most common ones was be aggressive.
Right.
As you're coming through the ball, just think, be aggressive. Don't just get the ball off your hand and stop. Follow all the way through.
A lot of people try and just get it off the hand and think it's going to happen from there.
Right.
You know, they have a fingertip ball, they have an aggressive ball, they're on a, you know, house pattern, and they think the ball is just going to naturally hook.
So. Right. So to get the follow through, you need to over-exaggerate.
Yeah, and at least in practice, you need to over-exaggerate, and then as that becomes more natural, it'll feel more natural, and it won't be that weird over-exaggeration.
Right. I watch you and you're in the videos, and it seems like you're coming all the way back to your back sometimes.
Yeah, it's all, yeah, and some of it is just, you know, muscle memory. That's what my body does now, but I truly believe your timing will dictate how much hook you get on the ball.
Right.
You don't have to be the strongest guy. You don't have to tear the cover off the ball like some of these guys you see. You just have to have it all in time when you get to the foul line.
Right. And don't try to increase revs by twisting your wrist. I know you mentioned it in your question, but don't come over the top of the ball.
Right.
You may think you're starting to spin the ball.
You're mistaking spin for revolution.
Right.
Just because the ball's doing this, that doesn't mean you're getting more revs in the ball.
Exactly.
I would do all of these things. I would go put a wrist device on. You can get one of the bigger ones that allows you to cup your wrist, which will help you. Mm-hmm. And you can even have it turn your wrist in or out, and it'll let you feel what it's like to get out of the ball that way. And then from there, you can go.
Exactly. Hope that answered your question. That was
yeah.
a long one, and kind of passionate about that.
Go for it.
Timing.
Yes, that's right.
All right, you want... to read?
I'll read, sponsor.
All right, you do that.
Okay, this week's episode is brought to you by Brunswick Bowling.
Yo.
I'm getting a little
gangster.
This week's episode is brought to you by Brunswick Bowling. Check out the all-new Nexus PR. I should have let you because I'm never sure how to say that. Check out the all-new Nexus Function P+R, the newest addition to Brunswick's Nexus series. The combination of the projection additive, new recovery additive, and the rotor core results in a ball motion with the highest hook potential and most continuation of any Brunswick ball to date. Be sure to check out the all-new Nexus Function P+R ball reaction video, as well as all the other new releases from Brunswick at bowlingball.com.
There you go.
That's not an easy name of a ball to say.
No, it's not.
So, shame on you.
Especially when they actually use the function symbol.
Yeah, I'm over it.
All right. If you have a question you'd like us to answer on this show, there are many ways to contact us. Emails, questions@talkbowling.com. Leave a comment on any episode of Talk Bowling on talkbowling.com. On Twitter, we are @talkbowling, or on Facebook, we are facebook.com/talkbowling.
Very good.
All right. Last episode, we asked who was the first professional athlete to endorse a major product brand on national TV and when. And we've got some responses. A lot, I think, had the right product, but the wrong person.
And the answer is Billy Hardwick. And he did Miller Beer in 1969.
We saw a lot of Don Carter. Somebody said Don Carter, Miller Beer.
Huh.
But I guess it was Billy Hardwick. I did not check to find out if this was the first athlete.
Or the first bowler.
First bowler.
Yeah, we'll find out. Maybe. Probably forget.
We'll forget after this.
All right, this week's question of the week. Who won the first ever PBA title using a reactive resin ball?
As opposed to, I guess, the old rubber ball?
It would have been urethane before that.
Gotcha. And rubber before that?
Yes.
What do I know? I didn't start till 2000s.
A couple decades off, but you're okay. Yeah, so who won the first PBA title using reactive resin ball?
All right. We have lots of things we're giving away.
Yes, we do.
And things pop up in the middle of the week sometimes.
Middle of the day. It's like it's crazy like, around here.
It's like, what's going on? All of a sudden,
we're giving stuff away. Okay, the big one that we have going right now is on bowlingball.com. You have a chance to win one of seven gift certificates we're giving away. We're giving away a $100 gift certificate, two $50 gift certificates, or four $25 gift certificates. Good on bowlingball.com. And all you have to do to get entered into that is like our bowlingball.com page.
Help us get to 10,000 right. Likes on bowlingball.com.
So if you go to the site under the Shop Smart on the right, there's a little link that take you to our promotions page. You can do all your liking there, and those will get you entries into that contest.
Yep. On the Path Facebook page, Pyramid Bowling Facebook page, we're doing a Choose Your Path contest. Help get us to 2,000 likes, and you could win your choice of a Pyramid Path arsenal, which includes ball, bag, and shoes.
Correct.
I forget where we're at. We're over 1,000.
Yeah, we were at 1,300, and we were just under halfway there, I think, when I looked yesterday.
Yeah.
And check out bowlingball.com's Facebook page throughout the day. They've been putting up contests for accessory packs just by commenting on posts or sharing posts. So
yeah.
It seems like they've been on a roll with that lately, so check that out.
Yes. I know this won't get out, but there's one happening today. I'm sure this episode will come out after.
I'm sure.
It's just constantly happening all of a sudden. All right, on bowlingball.com, we're giving away a bowling ball every week. 52 weeks, 52 winners. Come back to the site every week to enter for your chance to win the bowling ball that is being given away that week.
Correct. And we have Brunswick, DV8, Storm, and Rotogrip on board with that. So it's one of those four balls. And then if there's an odd week in there, we give away an OTB ball. Right, and on bowling boards, there is also a weekly contest. You get an entry for every post you make. So if you start a post, comment on a post, get in there and join the conversation, and for every post you make, you get an entry into that contest.
Yes, just participate in the conversation and earn your way to a new ball.
That's right. I didn't put any new releases in there, and it's a Brunswick episode. They're coming out really soon. There's a new Nexus coming out, the new C system, and the new Karma. So the C-System VersaMax Nexus Function P+R and the Karma Pearl Purple Pink will be releasing, I believe, early next week.
There you go. All right, in closing, please remember that bowlingball.com is free shipping on every item every day. No handling fees, no packaging fees, no added insurance fees. The price shown on the product page is the price you pay at checkout. No surprises.
That's right.
Thank you very much for watching.
Thank you.